Hello, everybody at reInvent. Today, we're coming to you from sunny Singapore, and we're really excited to have James and Sashi both here with us from Goldman Sachs. They're both executive directors of technology, and they've been working very closely with us on building out a managed file transfer service. James, Goldman Sachs is a really well-respected financial services firm. Can you tell me a little bit more about your role at the bank and what you've been doing on the project?
Sure. So I look after two tech teams there. So first of all, I look after the grid compute technology team. So that's the grid compute that's used for a lot of the risk and pricing throughout the bank, using quite a lot of cloud technology in there as well. So also I look after the MFT team. So we have our own internal MFT solution called SFX, and that's basically the file transfer solution.
Thanks. And Sasha?
Yeah, sure. I'm cloud enablement team lead. The cloud enablement team is responsible to bring in or enable public cloud technologies within the firm using industry best practices in an agile fashion. My other role is to work with different business departments, advise them on cloud migration, cloud design. Like one of the team I'm working with is SFX with James.
Okay, great. And Sashi, could you just tell us a little bit more about the importance of cloud at Goldman Sachs?
Sure. So I think this question has been answered by our leadership, like in many public forums, like reInvent and Investors Forum. I'll summarize quickly for you, right? So really two things. One is accelerate the innovation, right? And second is delightful developer experience, right? Make your developer more productive using bleeding edge, cutting edge technologies within the firm. And accelerate the innovation. What you really want to do is become a vertical bank, right? Using cloud technologies, do all the heavy lifting for our client, provide differentiated service, and digital platform, which basically meets all the regulatory and compliance requirements.
Thanks, Sashi. And James, could you just tell me a little bit more about the importance of managed file transfer for Goldman Sachs?
Yeah, of course. So if you think about it, data is really the lifeblood of a bank. We are nothing. We can't operate without data being interchanged between us and our regulators, us and our vendors and our clients. So we need to do that reliably every single day. So it's absolutely critical for our operation.
Thanks, James. And when I think of managed file transfer and I think of the financial services industry, obviously you guys are heavily regulated. You're working with trading partners. You've got a number of other partners that you have to interoperate with and exchange data with. Can you, James, give us an idea of the size and the scale of what you have to deal with on a daily basis?
Sure. So if you look at how many people that people and organizations that we have to interact with, this is means that we literally have to transfer millions of files every single day. So we're delivering files to people, we're collecting files from people, we're making files available to people. And this all has to be done very reliably. And we have to manage this very sort of bursty nature of this this delivery, because people need to access files at the right time. They need files delivered at the right time.
So the timeliness is incredibly important, I'm sure. And James, Goldman Sachs is, as I mentioned before, it's regulated. You guys have a lot of constraints on you, and also you've got a technology plant that's been in place for a long time, and I'm sure you've got constraints on how you integrate, et cetera, et cetera. Could you just sort of explain maybe some of the complexities and some of the things that you've had to deal with to actually implement a new managed file transfer service?
Yeah. So if you think about FTP, SFTP as a protocol, they're pretty old protocols, right? So, why is this even a hard problem? It's a hard problem because there are so many different implementations of these protocols. There are so many different remote system behaviors that we have to interact with. And we don't necessarily have any control over the, those implementations. So the problem is in the number of edge cases that we have to work around. You know, we have to provide a solution for our clients to interact with these highly heterogeneous systems.
Right, got it. And Sashi, just coming to you, like any other features or key requirements you need to meet?
I would pick up from where James like left. Like, so as James highlighted, like, you know, the scalability, availability, resiliency requirement, right? To have a highly available file transfer solution, right? The other bit which I would mention is, think about like, you know, you're going to be sending file to your clients or regulators or receiving file and sending within the firm, right? How do you ensure that, you know, the file is scanned, right? Yeah. File is safe to be distributed around, right? So definitely that I would count as a critical feature.
And James, could you sort of maybe explain to the audience at reInvent some of the complexities and challenges that you've had in implementing a managed file transfer service?
So, I mean, going back to the heterogeneous nature of what we're dealing with, you know, there is so much complexity in that. And that combined with the number of clients that we have to deal with, the number of internal business units that we have to deal with, this all compounds the complexity. But all of this has to meet SLAs, right? People want files delivered on time. If they send us a file that needs to be delivered to a regulator within X amount of minutes, that needs to go there on time. And they need to be confident that that can happen.
Right. So what sounds like a very simple service
yes.
is actually quite complex, especially when you're dealing with this kind of scale that Goldman Sachs
yes.
deals with.
Underneath this quite simple concept, this an ocean of edge cases and spikes in demand, this bursty nature that I was talking about, that really, really does add to the complexity of the solution.
Right. And Sashi, just coming to you, could you sort of explain like why Goldman Sachs didn't choose to carry on building their own service? Why did they choose to partner with us at AWS on building out a managed file transfer service?
Yeah, I would like think about it, right? What we are trying to achieve, like with all the scale and complexity aside, right? We are trying to send a file and receive a file. Mm. And it's an old protocol, right? Mm. Like why it is just not a commodity, right? Why we can't just, it's there, like, and then we can deliver file and receive file, right? Why do we need to maintain such a large piece of infrastructure, code, and deal with all these complexities? And we got like, you know, a question asked from our leadership, like, you know, why it is not a black box, right? And that's when, like, you know, we started thinking about what to do. And precisely 2 years ago, I was in reInvent, and I was discussing with your AWS Transfer Service about, like, you know, this is something we are thinking. And I think AWS Transfer Service recognized the industry-wide applicability, and they approached us that we can collaborate, and we shared our IP, like, you know, what we have learned over the years, and we are looking forward to, like, you know, what comes out of this.
Yeah, no, it's been a great partnership working with you guys. Like, you know, we've had the AWS Transfer Family team, we've had ProServe, we've had Amazon Managed Services all coming together and working very closely with Goldman Sachs to meet your requirements, and it's been fun. And James, I just want to come on to something which is more to do with the heart of the solution and really talk about, like, you know, at the heart you've got SFTP and you've got S3. And we mentioned a little bit earlier about workflows. Can you kind of zoom in and sort of talk about the features and what you see as the things that really act as a bit of a game changer for you?
So for me, the important part here is, you know, the ability to have these workflows, like you mentioned. So having workflows as part of this sort of file transfer workflow, it really gives the users a lot of power in terms of the routing and what happens to their file in transit. You know, and that kind of really makes this a platform for innovation, if you look at it that way.
Yeah. He used the right word, like platform of innovation, right? Like, and I'll expand on that, how it is platform of for innovation, right? Think about it, right? You receive the file. And you still need, like, people need to process that file, right? Mm-hmm. And you have all those sorts of data pipeline, like, you know, data analytics, building, rolling out your bespoke solution. Now, having that in the cloud and delivering that to an AWS S3 bucket really opens the door for us, right? Like you can build all your data pipeline, data analytics, AI, ML, what sort, what not. And it also further our cloud strategy.
Yeah, thanks. No, I really want to thank you both today for your time and sharing your story with everybody on stage at reInvent. And just to sort of summarize, like Goldman Sachs have been very pivotal in helping and inputting into the development for the AWS Transfer Family. And I'm sure the guys on stage will talk to you more about some of the future capabilities that are now being released. And I just want to thank James and Sashi again, really fantastic. And back to you on stage at reInvent. Thank you very much.